Hey everybody, and it's coming to you guys in part 5 of Ratchet and Clank, Up Your Arsenal. So today we'll be going back to the Starship Phoenix to play the Quark Vid comic. So let's go. Also, my girlfriend is really upset today that she has to spend a lot of money to get her wisdom teeth removed, and we don't have that kind of money right now. So, yeah, we're trying to figure out ways around that. Because at this rate, that's gonna hurt us something fierce. So here we go, the Starship Phoenix. Did you guys know this game is already 5 years old, like the remaster? Not the original. The original was like 2002, 2003, 2004? This game came out in 2012. And it's been so long. Pardon me, my throat's all, I don't know, weird today. Let's see, anything in here? Oh, we have way more than enough. Let's buy it! Here we go, getting a new look. Oh yeah, beautiful. I'll admit, the armor in this game is absolutely amazingly well designed. Let's save up for the spinning Hydra. So, without further ado, let's go to our quarters to play that Quark Vid comic. Yeah, I had issues uploading part 4 today, the day you're watching. The day part 4 is up is the day that I actually am recording this part, but yeah.
Watch and learn, Clank. This is how a real hero gets it done.
Clank looked evil again. He always seems to look evil in this game. Which is pretty sad. Nothing yet?
These are the real-life adventures of Captain Quark, the greatest superhero the galaxy has ever known.
Hey, this thing on?
Meticulously reconstructed by our crack research team with the aid of eyewitness accounts, bathroom gossip, wild speculation, and a magic ape. In the early days of the 5th Solarian Equinox, the Solana galaxy was terrorized by a notorious pirate known as Captain Blackstar.
Ahoy! Anybody else got a craving for fish and chips?
Though still in the prime of his youth, Captain Quark was already a living legend.
I was beating him up with a stick.
However, no previous adventure could have prepared Quark for his encounter with the dread pirate Blackstar and his crew of... Oh, please tell me this is a typo.
That's robotic pirate ghosts. Yes, reading wasn't your subject, eh, Professor?
Right. Now we begin the interactive portion of Episode 1. Booty is in the eye of the beholder.
Funny thing is Captain Blackstar is the original guy before Captain Slag in the future series. Also, there is a skill point for beating this within a certain amount of time. We're not going to be doing that till I mass do them all, so we won't see them for a while. Probably towards the end of the Let's Play.
The red ones are worth 10 Quark tokens.
That's nice, Quark. No one cares about your goddamn Quark tokens. I believe it's for a titanium bolt to get all of them. Yes, I said titanium bolt this time, not platinum bolt. Don't know why I always have a bad habit of saying platinum. And they're throwing goddamn heads at me. Literally, those are skulls. Give me this 10. We're almost halfway done collecting everything. Well, these platforms disappear, so move off of them fairly quickly. Wow, already 61. This mission isn't that difficult. Sometimes you'll have multiple comics to play at once, so we're going to be spending like an episode just playing comics. As for right now, we don't have to worry about that. Eventually, I believe we pick up weapons, but right now we just have our fists. Our fists of fury. God damn it, rats. Everywhere there's rats, man. Were they having sex in the corner? They were having sex in the corner, man. It's not right. Yay, robotic space eel. I don't know how that can haunt. How's it even dead? Can robots actually haunt things? I don't know if they can. Oh. Yeah, I can make it. Yeah, only about 26 more. Oh, 25. Man, there's a big gap between all the tokens, apparently. I always find that funny how like they put so many together and then it's like, oh yeah, we're not gonna put any more. Wow, one shot and he's dead. Okay, we're gonna have to go up here to get to him. Or, well, not him, it. It's just a token, not a person. Hey. I don't know how I made that. Man, one shot, yet so many punches. The gun is just that much more powerful.
Boop, boop.
Jump over that before it comes back up. Same with that one. Oh, looks like we got a, yep, a moving platform. Go figure. Okay. Ow, there's the titanium bolt after almost dying. That was painful. Yeah, they all take three hits to kill, except for the rats. The rats only take one. Ooh, a health upgrade.
Mm, a nice juicy health upgrade. Remember, cadets, there's one in every level.
I believe there's a skill point for also getting all the health upgrades at the end. That requires you to beat every level. Wait, these are only 10 shots, not full? Oh man, I think you can punch it, but it doesn't really do much to it. Yeah, we didn't get the time because you can see the time is grayed out. If it's grayed out, you didn't make it. There we go, almost dead. Give me some more ammo. Nope, we got the falling boulders. Oh, the ammo's going over here today. And there we go, it is destroyed, so we beat the Quark VidComic. Yeah! Yay, only game you get to play is Quark, I believe. Oh, and we're some bolts. I'm gonna say 5,000. Nope, more than 5,000. 6,000. I'm cool with that.
I mean, I've worked on some real junk, but this one takes the cake. Pirate, ghost, robots. I mean, what do they think? We're idiots?
Hey, Professor, snap to it.
Once again, the citizens of the Solana Galaxy owed their lives to the dauntless courage of the remarkable man behind the cube. With great reluctance, Quark accepted a meager fee for his services and promptly donated the entire sum to the Quark for Tots Scholarship Fund, a charity providing makeovers and buxom bimbos for needy people named Quark.
I've got a big heart. Mr. President? Yes, I got the fruit basket, thanks. It turns out I'm allergic to prunes. Yeah, who knew? What? Blackwater City is under attack. Yes, sir, I'm on my way.
The exciting, all true, right, adventures of Captain Quark continue in episode 2.
Yeah, the president is also Quark. That makes complete and utter sense. Freaking full of himself, dude.
Well, who's that handsome devil?
It appears Quark has regained his memory.
Hey, this dressing room isn't fit for a pig. What kind of shoddy production are you people running?
That's him, all right.
He may need a while to adjust. In the meantime, I've got a mission that's perfect for you two. We've just learned of a prototype holographic device that can disguise the user as a Tyranoid, even allowing him to speak Tyranese.
Is it just me, or do you smell bananas?
Anyway... The device happens to be the grand prize on this week's Annihilation Nation. Check it out.
Tonight on Annihilation Nation, we feature an all-new Death Course. Let's meet tonight's victim. Oops, I mean contestant, Fred. Fred is a Gadgetron accountant who claims he once had a morpho ray go off in his pants. What a champ. Let's take a look at what he's up against. Doesn't look too bad now, does it? Good luck, Fred! Next!
Wow.
Another day, another death course.
Yeah, we're used to it, don't worry. Station Q9, Annihilation Nation. Oh, hey, we have enough to get the Spitting Hydra. So I think we'll go and pick that up before we do anything else. Pardon me, I had a tickle in my throat. So we'll buy it.
Hold circle to target multiple enemies with the spitting hydra. Release circle to fire.
Sounds good to me. So let's hop into our ship. And we will be going to Annihilation Nation, win the tier, guys. So it's just like the pirate guys. Literally, it's the exact same thing. I believe there's one almost in every Ratchet and Clank game. Like, I mean almost every single game. Like, you can turn into a robot in the very first game. Now, you will be coming back here, what, 2-3 times? Maybe even 4. Which is absolutely crazy, but yeah, we'll be here a lot. Okay.
Are you ready to play? Alright, let's meet our first contestant. He's an unemployed rocket mechanic who claims to have saved 2 galaxies, but most people know him as Secret Agent Clank's bumbling chauffeur. He hopes that disguising himself as a Tyranoid will make him more attractive to the ladies.
Hey!
Give a warm welcome to Ratchet! Ratchet will attempt to be the first contestant ever to survive the Death Course. Contestant number 1, are you ready?
Bring it on!
Yeah, we're ready. Also, I believe there's a skill point for destroying all the cameras. Also, a skill point for not dying on the, or again, taking damage on the course. I believe enemies in this game, during like the arenas, actually level you up more. Oh, the laser cannons. Literally just do that. Very easy. Ooh, there's a platinum, titanium bolt up there. I believe platinum bolts are what were in Going Commando, which is funny that I remember that, because that's the game I probably played the least, but here we go. Oh, I didn't do the whole I picked it up thing. I'm fine with that, but still. Oh man, this is gonna be annoying. Nope, never mind. If you play Call of Duty, you know what you're doing. It's your first person mode. Man, I could see Ratchet and Clank going complete first-person mode. That would just, like, ruin the game, though. I don't think Insomniac would be that stupid. Insomniac's a good company. I believe in you guys. You guys are my favorite game company. Created Spyro and Ratchet and Clank, my 2 all-time favorite games. So, I can't complain. Oh, little buzz dudes that are all just chilling here. Like, look how fast my weapon's leveling. That's crazy insane. One random robot guy, okay. Not all the courses are this long or designed this way. I believe Into the Nexus has the shortest arena, but then again, Into the Nexus was literally like a $30 or $40 game. It might have been like $29.99. I don't think it was worth very much. So that's why it was a shorter game. Not like these games, which were full price games. Boom! And we should get the skill point. Yep, perfect. And we got a Quark VidComic. Arriba Amoeba.
Now it's time to get
down and dirty. Low down. Okay, cool. Sounds good to me. These guys have armor. It's kind of cool how you like bust it off. Wow, 10 rounds for this? Really? It's a lot different than the other arenas. Man, the new arenas are wussy compared to these old ones. Oh, and there we go. V3. Hey, we got the lock-on mod.
This weapon upgrade features a lock-on mod. To lock on to enemies, press and hold L2 and R2.
Yeah, see what I'm doing right there? It does that, and what it does is it'll show health, but since those enemies only have like 1 health, they don't really show much. Oh god damn it. I don't think there's a skill point though for not taking damage here. You can't actually use enemies to kill each other, though. That's kind of cool. Man, this weapon levels up slow. I'm not gonna lie. Probably better to fight these little guys, eh? Maybe. I don't really know. Just die already, guys. Okay. Oh, I did. I was abandoned on a planet, man. My family doesn't love me. Let's try this out. Oh god, that levels up so slowly. Bzzzt. It does do a lot of damage, though. It was the most expensive weapon we could get at this time frame. So might as well use it now, eh? Oh, still more of these little guys. Goodbye, little guys. Ah, we're out. Well, we have one more shot. Now let's use the plasma whip. I just realized how underleveled our weapons are. Then again, I don't know if they're considered underleveled yet. And there we go. Congratulations.
I don't believe it, folks. He survived the death horse. And here to give you your prize, the lovely Miss Courtney Gears. How about that, folks? He is better looking.
Do not be alarmed, Sasha. That is Ratchet.
Oh, I see you won the terror guys. It's very convincing. Anyway, there's something I think the two of you need to see.
Work personal log entry 101301. After I personally vanquished the protopet menace and revamped the Megacorp testing facility, I decided to focus my efforts on protecting the endangered creatures of the Florana jungle. But when news arrived that Dr. Nefarious had again risen to power, I knew where my true destiny lay. The training necessary to get back into tip-top shape has been exhausting, and my mind overflows with brilliant concepts. Though I still yearn for the bittersweet stench of my simian companions. Time has come to resume my duties as the greatest hero the galaxy has ever known, Captain Quark!
That full of himself, biatch.
You're not gonna believe this, but the President put Quark in charge of the fight against Nefarious. Our new commander just called his first team meeting. You better get back to the Phoenix right away.
I agree. This does not sound good.
Nope, it doesn't. But anyways, let's go in here. We can do more missions. Well, more challenges. The Terrible Two. Fight two gladiators for a big cash prize of 4,000. Natural launcher. Let's try you. Actually, for this one, it's whatever weapon you want to fully upgrade. That you want to upgrade to use to kill them. Yeah, see, there's their health bar. If you hold down L2 and R2, you get the health bar. See, it works on them. Oh, you're toast. And you're halfway defeated. I believe you also have a timed mission for this. It's kind of like the future arena as well. You have a lot of similar concepts in these games as each other. I'm gonna bring her down all the way, so I don't want to finish her off yet. God, this guy's got a lot of missiles. Wait, did she die? Yep, she died. Man, that barely leveled it up. Come on, man. Alright, let's see if we can charge it up. Sorry, I just gotta click. I had to click something. It was, causing the thing to go a little weird. And there we go! 4,000 bolts. Beautiful. Robot Rampage! Floor traps, flame jets, and flying turrets, oh my! So let's do it.
Now it's time to get
down and dirty! With a lowdown showdown! See, people like this concept so much that that's why they made Deadlock. That's actually the reason why. And I really like that. I'm just trying to level this weapon up to V3. And there we go! Aw, oh, wait, is that the lock-on mod? Don't know if that's the lock-on mod or just way more damage. Oh, sometimes the charge attack doesn't work on it. Really hate that. Anyways, you're still V2. Burn, baby, burn! Ooh, ooh, ooh! Oh, hey there, robots! Alright. This isn't going too bad so far. It does take a lot of ammo to kill these guys, though, for a very little experience. Why would you want to see a shaved Lombax? How do you guys all know I'm a Lombax? I'm the last one in the galaxy, like, how do they always know what I am?
Boom.
Wow, that was an easy round, right? No, I don't need the Inferno power-up unless things get too rough. So this right, it's better for me not to use it. Boom. There we go. There, and what else do we need? We can use you. Beautiful. Oh, we got the sentry. Now this is what you use Inferno for. Is to avoid taking damage from the turret that pops up in the middle. At least that's what I use it for. You can also destroy enemies. Ooh, maximum nanotech increase. Yow! Lava still hurts you though. Watch out for that. Dude, why did my wrench use circle to attack? That's weird. That was odd. Anyway, 6,000 volts. Two-minute warning. Beat Gary and Helen before time runs out. It doesn't tell you how much time you have. 2 minutes. Boom. This weapon actually doesn't do that much. Like, it's a decent amount, but that was 5 out of 15 ammo. Thank you, thank you. Ah ha ha! Okay, you're gone. Who's next? Wait, obviously I know who's next. Depends on where she is, that's what I meant to say. Wait, why did I ask how much time we had? It's called 2 minute warning for a reason. Okay. Oh, come on, man. Oh, goddammit, I got hit by the dumbest attack ever. And there we go, she's toast. That was worth no experience whatsoever. Dude, come on. You know what? No. Just use this weapon. Why did you switch? Dummy. And there we go. Defeated. And we got yet another nanotech upgrade. Crispy Critter. Navigate a lethal obstacle course featuring fire traps, breakaway floors, push blocks, and killer robots for only 2,000 bolts. So you can kind of figure that's not going to be that difficult. So anyway, you know what? You're starting to piss me off there, camera. Well, you have a psychotic way of saying it's too much. Oh my god, I don't even know what I'm saying. It's a psychotic meaning of fun.
Hey, be sure to catch me next week at the Florana Demolition.
There, just gotta destroy as many cameras as possible. Also, gotta deal with all these little robots.
Look at those beady little eyes. He's got that 1,000-yard stare.
No, I don't. I'm just awesome. God damn it, how did I take damage there? Hey, what's up there then? Seems a little suspicious to have a random platform up here with some random lava for no absolute reason. Oh, I guess just to show me that there's gonna be enemies up there? Okay, and why are you not targeting that enemy? Why are these guys so dumb? Wow, another nanotech increase? God, these enemies give you way too much nanotech, yet not enough weapon experience. Did I miss any cameras out there? I hope I didn't. I want to try and get all the cameras done.
Boom.
Oh, and there's the skill point. Perfect. There's also a titanium bolt over there that I don't think we can get.
Boink.
What do we got next? Nothing. Ninjas. Hey there, guys. This weapon just levels up so fast in this game because of how much ammo it gets. Like, it's absolutely insane. There we go. Pyro Playground. Navigate a lethal obstacle course featuring fire traps, breakaway floors, push blocks, and killer robots. I don't get why that says the exact same thing. Hey, maybe we'll be able to get that titanium bolt that we seen. There is another skill point for defeating one of the bosses, but we don't have that boss yet, and you need to beat it with your wrench.
Boom, boom.
Well, they're all dead. Just long jump out of there. Seems a little easy, don't you think? Like, this is even easier than, like, the first obstacle course. I can also get that titanium bolt up there again.
Boom.
Man, that one summons out a lot of little robots. Uh-oh. No! God damn it. Can't believe we had that fail. There we go.
Push the button to flip the side.
I know how to do it, dude.
Do
those actually give you, like, bolts or anything? They do. How many? 50. At this point in the game, that's not worth that much. Not really worth just specifically destroying them over and over for. There's a demolition derby in the jungle. It's not very nice. Poor jungle. Boom, boom, boom. God, man, you gotta time this just right. And I don't believe that's the end. Nope, it's not the ending. At least we're doing better this time. I'm assuming this way. Nope, not that way. I am going all the way, man. What do you think I'm doing? Anyways, in we go for 3,000 bolts. Suicide run. It says the exact same thing, so I'm not gonna say it again. God damn it, that was bad.
Alright.
See, where are we going this time? Over this way. This is gonna be a longer video, probably the longest. Not the longest in the series, because there is gonna be a part of this game where it's gonna take me a lot to do. But this is gonna be the longest part in probably the first half of the Let's Play, at least. And I'm just gonna ignore you guys, because you guys are annoying. Goodbye, guys. Oh, hey, ninjas! Ninjas are always cool. Don't know why we made robot ninjas, though. Get out here, little dude. Why do I always choose the wrong way?
Oh, man. This job is
hey, there's that. There's that platinum or titanium bolt again. Why do I keep saying platinum? Is this the one where it's like a random ninja right here? Oh, I thought that was the one where it's a random ninja.
Note to self, never mess with a trigger-happy long...
That's a joke, right? There, 90 seconds of carnage. You know what? In the next episode, we're actually going to finish all of this, guys. So if you like this...